This morning I have come across this mature male Assamese macaque, and he is blocking my way. But with canines like that, I am not inclined to force the issue. You may have noticed that actually he has lost the top right canine, and perhaps as a result the lower right one is protruding outside of his lip, making this individual very easy to identify. Here, just beside him, sitting in the bamboo, are two more males, so still and quiet that I didn't notice them at first. Since filming this, I've learnt that until recently this troop was led by a very aggressive male that had even attacked visitors to this area. He appears to have disappeared, and it is presumed that he has died somewhere in the forest, and it seems that the troop is adjusting to a new hierarchy. It is mid-morning, and the light is just gorgeous. As I looked around, I began to notice several more small groups in the bamboo, and very slowly and quietly moved my gear to find the right angles for filming. The two males have been joined by an adolescent, which I presume to also be a male, and perhaps these three constitute a small bachelor group. What does that lip smacking mean? Please leave a comment if you have any thoughts on that. These Assamese macaques are mostly found in parts of Asia to the north of Thailand, so this group is close to the southernmost part of their range. I was very interested to see how trusting this adolescent was with this mature male. Fascinating. And now, for the first time, we get a clear view of one of the females that was at the back of the bamboo before. Very distinctive with this facial injury or disfigurement, and nursing a gorgeous newborn. I wonder what happened to this mother. Is this the result of a fight, or was she born this way? And here, what I am assuming to be an older sister to this baby. and I think she would like to cuddle the baby too. But she'll have to be content with grooming Mum. Now, another nursing female joins this group, and the adolescent appears to give way. I wonder what the relationship is between these two mothers. I'm sure it is very close. It seems that being a macaque is itchy work. What a wonderful sight. Just look at those delicate hands. The adolescent here goes off to explore, but in the whole time I was filming, I did not see him interact closely with any other young macaques. The group seems very quiet, but perhaps pensive. And a small noise in the forest clearly frightens them. Is it possible that they are still concerned about the whereabouts of the aggressive dominant male that was until recently in this troop? The larger female now has both infants with her. Clearly, there is considerable trust between these two mothers. Are they sisters, or perhaps mother and daughter? Well, the younger mother moved her infant to a patch of bamboo to my left, and her journey brought her close to where I was standing, so I stopped filming and fell back to give her room to pass. Absolutely delightful to see this infant exploring its world a little bit, but always within an arm's reach of Mum. And here is the larger of the two females we saw before, and her baby looks to be even younger than the other one. Watch the baby closely here. A little slip, and Mum's supporting hand is out almost instantly. The rest of the troop seems to be on the move to the same bamboo now, and I'm wondering if this large individual is the same male that we saw at the beginning. The lonely, if I can say that, adolescent approaches the family group, but keeps some distance. And here is another one climbing on its own. I wonder why. Well, it doesn't take long for the two nursing mums to be reunited. But this one is definitely more concerned about my presence, and they move a little bit further back into the bamboo. Not food. At last, what I was hoping for, the two babies together. Again, this male seems to be watching out for everyone. Is he the top male in this troop now? Oh, the joys of grooming. As he turns his head, we can see that this is the same male that we saw at the beginning with the protruding canine.